From supernatural artifacts that can bring the dead back to life to terrifying mutants born from child experimentation, there's a lot more to the forest than meets the eye. Here's everything you need to know about this cannibal-filled horror story before its sequel, Sons of the Forest, launches later in 2022. The story begins with TV survival expert and recent widower Eric LeBlanc and his son Timmy on a flight to, well, you never find out exactly, because as soon as the in-flight entertainment begins... The plane breaks apart and nosedives into an area known as the Peninsula. Battered and dazed, Eric sees a mysterious man covered in red paint kidnap Timmy before falling unconscious. Hours later, Eric has two objectives: find Timmy and set up camp, with one feeling far more pressing than the other. But first, there's one very important question.
Guys, where are we?
A century ago, religious missionaries arrived on this mysterious stretch of land and declared their love of God to its inhabitants. Unfortunately for them, the locals happen to be cannibals. While their exact origins aren't explained, clues like these notes left behind by the missionaries suggest the cannibals have been here for a very long time. The same clues also point to countless failed attempts by the missionaries attempting to defend themselves, which begs the question, why venture here in the first place? It's all to do with this otherworldly obelisk. Fast forward to the modern day, and a genetics company called Sahara Therapeutics has purchased the land where the cannibals reside to begin construction of an underground research laboratory. Sahara set up Site 1, an underground research lab dedicated to healing children suffering from terminal illnesses. But the reality is it's conducting experiments on children using the obelisk, which has the power to resurrect them, but to do so requires a sacrifice. Yikes. And remember the man covered in red paint? He's Dr. Matthew Cross, who's spearheading clinical trials on children called the Jarius Project. Unsurprisingly, they don't go according to plan and result in creating a bunch of horrific mutants. Inevitably, the mutants escape and kill Dr. Cross's own daughter Megan, so Cross plans to use Timmy as a sacrifice to resurrect his daughter using the obelisk. Thankfully, Eric is no stranger to surviving in the wilderness and is more than happy to chop, smash, and eat his way through the local population to save Timmy. Wait a minute.
Are we the baddies?
Eric encounters a gigantic sinkhole, which happens to be between him and the entrance to the lab. Eric eventually comes across the entrance to the abandoned facility and finally enters. As Eric explores the research lab, he finds many of Megan's drawings. Could this mean she's alive and somewhere nearby? Eventually, Eric finds Timmy in the lab, but he's already dead. Turns out Dr. Cross had already used Timmy to resurrect Megan. Eric has no choice but to find Cross and put a stop to this once and for all. But he's already dead, his body riddled with multiple stab wounds from a crayon? Turns out that the recently resurrected Megan just killed her own father. Whoops. Eric eventually finds Megan, who mutates into a properly disgusting beast that spawns deformed babies, but Eric defeats her and attempts to use her corpse to bring back Timmy. Turns out a live sacrifice is required. This guy really can't catch a break, can he? But there's a twist. There's a second obelisk, which Dr. Cross used to knock your plane out of the sky. So do you continue the cycle, choosing to take down another plane, which in turn allows you to save your son by sacrificing someone else's child? Or do you take the noble path of breaking the cycle by shutting a device down for good, losing Timmy forever in the process? Your decision determines everything from here on in, and picking the latter sees Eric leaving both Timmy's body and memory behind. Choosing this option allows the game to continue as normal, with Eric staying on the island and allowing you to continue your self-made journey with the cannibals. If, however, you choose the selfish option, Eric fires the energy cannon at another plane passing by, and then things get really weird. A year later, Eric and Timmy make an appearance on a late-night talk show. Eric is asked to compete in a tree-chopping competition live on air because why not? But then Timmy suffers a seizure, much like Megan did before she mutated into a spider-legged freak. But Timmy recovers moments later, and we're left thinking everything is okay. Or is it? Soon after, we see Timmy, now a young adult living in the city, his apartment strewn with empty bottles of pills and booze. He then suffers another seizure, his skin contorting, before... Oh, sweet. Achievement unlocked. Will we find out what happens to Timmy next in the sequel Sons of the Forest, or was his fate sealed in that cutscene? Or will we return to the island and the obelisks, and will their reign of terror finally be put to a stop? We'll have to wait and find out, but we hope the dreadful late-night talk show doesn't make another appearance. But for more on the forest and its sequel, make sure to stick with IGN.